I love all fields of science.
In one word, if I were to describe science, it would be development.
I think science in one word to me means opportunity.
It's always changing.
I like the innovation in science, how science and innovation are hand in hand.
Just being able to create something that can benefit mankind.
Science is my life, I would say.
I think I've developed a really good, language independent, easy to implement, inexpensive, great project that I think could be very beneficial to many quadriplegics around the world.
So I've created a computer program that can help reduce the risk of vitamin D deficiencies and skin cancer.
My project looked at a malfunctioning gene in cancer cells.
It was about monopole magnets, which are magnets that only have one pole. We're getting really close to finding them and discovering more things about them, so I thought, well, we probably should have a good go and see what I can do.
My project is about the effect of estrogen on the ovatestis of the snail.
Looking at how we could control the virulence of certain bacteria such as E. coli.
I made plastic from potato starch and strengthened it with natural fibres.
The reason I enjoyed school so much was learning new things every day, so being able to learn new things even in science has been a big drive for me.
I've contracted whooping cough, swine flu and pneumonia, and so I've looked in the drawer and I've seen all the spoons are different sizes, so I thought a spoon's meant to hold 5 millilitres, but how can all these spoons possibly hold 5 millilitres? Then I saw all the measuring cups and I thought in my head, how accurate are they and what's their delivery technique? And that formed the basis of my project.
My project was about to see if I can improve my dyspraxia because I get teased a lot at school, so I decided to see if I could fix it.
My project is about sunscreen and antioxidants.
Air quality / gas sensor that automatically connects the internet and shares the information across all of your devices instantaneously.
I discovered a biomonitor which can indicate some pollution as you move next to the roads, and it's also found in high numbers on next to the roads, so it's a very appropriate biomonitor.
My project's about alternative way to make wind into energy.
It detects the presence of a child left in a car in a dangerous situation.
My project is about Atrospira maxima, which is also known as spirulina, and it is often regarded as the superfood of the future. So I try to enhance its nutritional value and also make it produce more in order to satisfy global demands for food.
Is a engineering project on a centerless water turbine.
My device was a puzzle, like Operation. Does everyone know the game?
Do I aspire to being a scientist? I'd say so. I think science is very interesting and I think I'm passionate about it.
Well, I mean, define scientist.
I graduated last year and hopefully I'm going to go into either medicine or pharmacy or somewhere, something like that.
My heart wants to do theology. I really want to do theology, and I'd love if I could blend physics and theology in my future.
Yes, I've always loved science. Actually, usually I like physics and chemistry more than biology, which is what this project is. At school I never even did biology. But for some reason, I was just really attracted to nutrition, so I just went along with the flow.
Problems that I've encountered.
The end magnets were so strong, it repolarized the center magnet in about 3 seconds and then decided to stick to one of the end magnets.
Yes, I did encounter a few problems, such as the write-up and deadline meeting and equipment, the method. But in the end, I was able to do it.
Not many problems. I think the problems were more about knowing what to do next.
Well, just between you and me, one of the snails escaped.
So I did have a few dramas along the way, but I'm happy with the end results and I'm happy how I got there.
I don't think there were any problems. It went pretty smoothly.
I guess one problem may have been I was carrying a tray full of cells and growth media, and thankfully it was in a box, but I did sort of slip and
the cells sort of all spilled throughout the box.
It's great to be in a group where so many enthusiastic scientists, future scientists are around, yeah.
Yeah, it's astounding me what they've been researching in and looking into. It's very amazing, interesting stuff. It's very diverse in terms of content, what they're doing.
The projects that I've seen are incredibly innovative.
I am very interested in psychology. That's the part of science that I'm most interested in. But I'm also interested in lots of other things like art and history and literature. I quite like the idea of being a scientific journalist. I think that would be very interesting.
In one word, I think science to me is wonder. You get to discover so many new ideas and so many new things. You get to explore. It is a very interesting path that you can take.
There's just so many things you can do with it. We've focused on space and we haven't gotten down to humans, and you can change things within a person, and that's a bit controversial, but is it really fair to let someone be an asthmatic when you have the power to change it, or, you know, could develop the power? It just seems interesting. I want to go into genetics for all of that stuff.
The results of my project show that data might be potentially used to minimize the threat of the oil and make it easy to collect in a way which is cheap, non-toxic and potentially profitable.
My final results showed that I was able to reduce cancer survival from 35% to 10% with the drug that I was using.
Yes, this is completely new research and there are lots of paths to go down in the future.
There's a large scope for our world, a big scope for future research.
Science, in one word, I think it's curiosity, because that's what brings us to want to know things. And I think that's a very human thing, and that's where science comes from.
Creation.
I'm just passionate about it, and I just love it.
Just like the concept of knowing new things that are around the world, that occur subconsciously around me. And knowing them makes me feel better.
So that, I don't know. I don't know where the future leads, because no one knows where their future leads.
That is a very difficult question. What does science mean to me? Truth.